Hello, this is a comparison between the LEGO Star Wars clone turbo tank from 2016 and 2006. So one full decade apart. LEGO has changed quite a lot. And, you know, I've decided that I'm not going to be too careful about what I say here and presenting it in the most balanced way. I'm just going to tell you how I feel, just straight up. Now, first of all, to frame the discussion, both of these cost the same. Adjusted for inflation, the price is exactly identical between the two. And I will show you the full sets, because these are just the main, you know, main assemblies, the stars of the show, but there's a lot of other stuff to see when it comes to kind of determining value, you know, with the figures and the other kind of side builds that are included. But same price, significantly more parts, about 90 more parts with this one. However, it is obviously much smaller. It certainly looks smaller. The visual impact of it is far less. And so that immediately is gonna make a lot of eyes and brains say, well, this obviously is not a fair view of it when you have one in closer to the camera, but there you go. That shows you a much better, you know, comparison. It's gonna make a lot of eyes and brains say, well, this one is better because it's bigger. That's a very simplistic way of looking at it, but a very valid way of looking at it. Generally speaking, all other things held the same, If you have a chance to get more for the same amount of money, you want to get more for the same amount of money. So this definitely looks like you get a better value for the same price with this much larger thing. I can tell you that this newer one feels so much more sturdy than the old one, and all the gaps close up much better. You look at all the seams around the edges and all the spots where things come together, it just fits better. A great example of that is here at this rear cab. They have some gaps, so that's important to note and to see. You know, it's not absolutely perfect, but you compare that to the old ones, or the old one, and its gaps, you know, much wider. Just, things just feel more loose in general, and just overall, just moving this around, you can see little panels flopping around. Just the quality level of this one feels lower to me compared to this. This is much more stable. It's also just a more dense build. Let me tell you some more things that I like better about this one. So the size is definitely a major thing, but the inside of this one I like better. I'll take this out and include that with the look at all this stuff together. But this one has a relatively simple studded base. I mean, it's a single large plate piece, and you can take just a few things out that were used to hold this turret in place, and you can put all kinds of dudes in there. It's really easy to just, you know, stack all sorts of figures up in there, and that's a really good thing. The new one actually opens up much better. Both, you know, the whole thing opens up from end to end of the main section of the hull. It is a smaller space in there, but more critically, they don't give you any studded space in there. Now, you could take out these long tiles that are included in there to allow you to easily put this ATRT, once it's all folded up, into place, and it won't get stuck or anything. You can take those off, and then you can still put troops in there, but there are holes in between. It's just much nicer to have a proper floor. I personally like the shaping of the older one just a little bit better. In spite of the gaps, it just feels like it has a little bit more personality. Some of the angles are a little bit more extreme, and especially the rear cabin section. I don't know if it's more realistic like this, but it just talks to me a little bit more. You know, there are more colored pieces included on there as well. Also, this one has the rear-facing cannons. The new one really doesn't. And I much prefer the observation post on the old one to the new. On the new, it's fine. It has a little printed console there, and when you put a figure on it, I'm just gonna put myself on it, it looks kind of appropriate, and you can rotate it around, and it's got a nice little geared mechanism on the inside. You open up the side, and there's a knob in there that allows you to bring it up and down. Technic mechanism works out pretty well. This is fine for the scale, but this is just much more, it just looks much better and is definitely much more realistic to the in-universe design. Now, when I did my review of this, I noted that this was always going to stay up, However, many of you corrected me on that and said, no, you can rotate it and it'll go down. Well, I tried rotating it and making it go down and it wouldn't. However, it's because of the old Lego standards where they would let you do things or let the designers do things that were really not good for the parts. You just have to rotate it extra. You have to put a little extra force into it and it'll actually push a piece past up in there. It actually does not fit, but you can force it to flex the axle significantly and then it'll go past. So this actually, come on. Oh my goodness, come on. There we go. This actually will allow you to retract the thing, but still sticks up quite a bit. But I personally just, oh man, I cringe every time. I definitely like the look of this better. Let me tell you some more things that I like more about the new one, besides just the gaps and the general more solid feel of it that I mentioned already. This one has the spring-loaded shooters on the side, which you can load up with bolts if you want to, or you can leave them out. I think that's a nice feature to actually physically be able to shoot. This one has a nicer little point defense cannon up on the top because it actually has spots where you can hold on like handlebars for a figure. You know, the other one had the same kind of feature, but it just doesn't have any place where you can hold on to it. So this is a little bit better to me. Also, at the back, while this one does not have the guns coming out from underneath, it has this turret up on the top, which feels way better than the old one, which was at more of an angle, which I liked that angle, but here, this tends to want to fall down, and this, again, feels kind of flimsy. But this one is just for pretend, which is fine, but this one can be used for pretend if you want, or you can actually physically shoot it with the stud shooters. I like having that option, as long as it doesn't make the thing look bad, and in this case, I feel like it doesn't make it look bad. I like the steering mechanism on the new one better. Keep in mind, we're looking at the rears of these now. These are the backs, officially Canon and all media according to Lucasfilm, blah, blah, blah. These are the backs. So if with the new one, I wanted to turn right, what I actually do is lean the whole thing to the right. And four axles will help to steer in that direction. It's a decent turning radius. I wish it would turn a little bit more quickly than that, just for the sake of play. It's probably a little bit more realistic like this, but I want to go right, so I lean to the right. I want to go left, I lean to the left. It's the exact opposite with the old one. If you want to go right, lean to the left, and only the axles at the ends will turn. It doesn't give you that good of a turning radius, doesn't give you that much friction, you know, that much traction with those steering axles. And this is actually probably more realistic. This is more how it would go in real life. If you're turning right, the whole thing's gonna lean to the outside. But to me, it just feels better to lean in the direction where you want to go. Though the sizes of these are very different, the usable cab space is not as different as you would expect from the size. Now at the rear, this one only allows you to put a single person in there. This one allows you to put two people in there. This one has a little bit more detail on the inside, but it's not that useful. I think personally it's better to have two seats than to have one. At the front though, this one opens up nicely wide. Everything opens up and here you have two seats. The old one, this part opens up and just this part opens up and that's it. That's all that you can do. It's a little bit backwards, and this one only carries one single person in the front. Between those two options, I think it's better to have two people that can sit at the front and one at the back, compared to two at the back and one at the front. This also has just a little bit more detail in the front, but honestly, I feel like this one actually looks a little bit better inside just because this has so many different colors and a lot of the Technic stuff is showing through. Now here I've set up all the stuff that came with each of these sets, and I've been very careful to put a line, an imaginary line, right through the center of your screen, of the video itself. So everything on the left-hand side, from here to the left, is all in the 2006 version, everything here is in the 2016 version, and you're seeing it all at the same scale. So I feel like this is a fair view of the difference in mass and volume of stuff that you got with one versus the other. And from here, I think that I can make do a fair summary of my thoughts, you know, conclude and give you my choice between these two, which I think was the better deal, which is the better two to own. I think this is the better to own. You really do get more stuff, or you did get more stuff, by quite a fair margin. The new one is a better build. It's more solid. It has more that it can do, but there's just so much more stuff here. Yeah, this has its gaps. It has its flimsiness. It has its illegal, what today would be considered an illegal technique with this. Oh boy, come on. Very cringeworthy thing there. That's no big deal though, really. You know, worst case scenario, that one part breaks after a while. This came with a speeder. This came with an ATRT. Both of them are very nice, but this also came with a turret that was deployable. This came with two more figures. Two of the figures here also came with more add-on accessory stuff with this deployable turret. That's useful. This guy had a jetpack and a heavy blaster. That's useful. Over here, we got two Jedi. Here you only got one Jedi, but you got a lieutenant. These are analogous to each other. All told, I mean, the space, the negative space, the empty space, really speaks for itself. I think that this shows how LEGO is making things that are smaller, that come with more pieces, that give you a better value in terms of price to part versus the older stuff, and yet the older stuff can still seem like it gives you a better deal because there's just more volume here. And this is a perfectly playable thing, even if it did have some things that felt shaky or wouldn't stay on all the time, like for instance these locks I didn't even mention in this video, but sometimes you open that and this part just comes off because it's not locked down. It doesn't have anything coming over the top. By today's building standards, they would have covered that up. They wouldn't have allowed that to go through. But I will take just that if I want to. I can add a piece today over the top, or even back then I could add a couple of pieces to hold that down, but I would take all that extra interior space over this lack of interior space and this very messy looking interior any day, to this very day. I am a big fan of where LEGO has gone in general with their building standards, and I try to take a pretty objective look at value of things and seeing what you're actually getting for what you pay, and I see that the price to part ratios have come down consistently in the past decade or two, and licensed products on the whole do not cost more price to part ratio than unlicensed products. There's a ton of really ridiculously expensive stuff in the City line and other, you know, lines that LEGO does where there's no IP involved, there's no Disney involved. You know, there are a lot of silly arguments that are easy to debunk with hard data that say that, you know, the newer stuff is worse and the newer stuff gives you less. But here, the newer stuff definitely gives you less. It is unmistakable. It's undeniable. It's more parts, and I'd say definitely better quality, but less stuff. Let me know what you think. Share your thoughts in the comments down below. I'm eager to hear your thoughts and different opinions. I appreciate your time and hope this has been a useful video for you. Talk to you again soon.